City Hall of Kuala Lumpur being the planning authority, we are in charge of the planning and development of Kuala Lumpur. We give approval to all development application in Kuala Lumpur. We would like to be the world class city. This is in line with the government vision 2020. The government has planned for the ETP, the Economic Transformation Program, to make Kuala Lumpur as the headquarters for 100 leading multinational companies. Second is to have connectivity from Kuala Lumpur to Singapore, whereby there'll be a high-speed train. And third is to have the MRT at the first line from Sungai Buloh to Kajang. It carries more than 500,000 passengers per day. And the fourth one is we have the River of Life, whereby the project is to clean the river. Then we have the promotion of the greening of the city. And lastly is to have a comprehensive pedestrian network in Kuala Lumpur. So with all this agenda, we hope to be a world-class city in the near future. As you know, MITEC, Malaysian International Trade Exhibition Center at the Jalan Duta, has been completed and now under operation. This is a big project launched by NASA. The development in Kuala Lumpur is very rapid. The KL Merdeka, if you see the signature tower will be taller than KLCC or KL Tower. When you arrive in Kuala Lumpur, you will be surprised to see that the standard of road in Kuala Lumpur is as the same as overseas in Europe or UK. All in all, we'll be spending more than 1 billion Malaysian ringgit to improve area along Jalan Turaza, Jalan Ampang, Jalan Jelati, and the southern part of Kuala Lumpur. And there will also, beside that, there will also be some privatized highway, namely the SPE, Siti Wangsa Pantai Expressway, the SUKE, the Sungai Besi Ulu Klang Expressway, and also Dash, that is the Damansara Shah Alam Expressway. I think there is potential for people to invest in Kuala Lumpur. As you can see now also, when people come to Kuala Lumpur, they will ask whether it's good to invest in Kuala Lumpur. Recently, there is the World Urban Forum 9 in Kuala Lumpur. There are more than 160 countries participating in that conference. I met a few of the mayors in Kuala Lumpur, and I explained to them that it's easy to invest in Kuala Lumpur. You can invest in agriculture, you can invest in engineering, you can invest in civil engineering, you can invest also in housing development, IT. There's a lot of opportunity in Kuala Lumpur. When you invest in Kuala Lumpur, you need people like engineers, architect, accountant. They are all here. You can just hire them. There are a lot of incentive by the government. Say you invest in Kuala Lumpur, there will be some tax exemption in terms of ease of doing business. We are among the top, maybe top 20 in the world. Within 2 or 3 months, we can also approve any development project in the city. Now the opportunity is to have this bandar wawasan. This, I think, will attract foreign countries to invest in Kuala Lumpur, because this will be another area in Kuala Lumpur that will be developed. And with the HSR, the high-speed train from Kuala Lumpur to Singapore, of course, this area will be one of the attracted area for investors to come to Kuala Lumpur.